there are two types of drug interactions. There is a drug interaction type where our body is acting on the drug and changing the drug or metabolizing the drug into our bodies. And those are very well known. We've been studying them for decades. But there's another type that happens at a different level where the drug is actually acting on your body. And those type are very poorly understood. So we're really interested in identifying these dangerous effects that can occur to anybody when they take multiple drugs in combination. It's an area that's very understudied. So what we're doing is using really large amounts of data that are available to us from electronic health records that are collected every time a patient might visit a doctor's office or be admitted to the hospital. And we're using those to identify when adverse events occur. The speed of this research has advanced incredibly because of the availability of these very large clinical data sets. And because of that, we are able to focus on writing computer algorithms to sift through all of these data to identify these signals for us. And that can happen very fast. And we can do it very rigorously so that we're sure about the statistics and we're sure about the medicine that's involved. One of the things that happens with these clinical data sets is that not everything is captured. Not every adverse event report is captured by the FDA, or you don't always go to the hospital when you're sick. Sometimes you just get better. And so when things are not captured like that, it's called a missing data problem. And this missing data problem can really confound a lot of statistical algorithms. And so what we did is we developed a new algorithm so that, like astronomers looking for black holes, where they use the gravitational pull on other planetary bodies or other star systems to infer the presence of that missing data, that black hole that they can't look at directly, we do exactly the same thing. We use the presence of other more commonly reported events like nausea and vomiting and headache, which are very commonly reported and very easy to identify in these systems. And we use them in a certain combination to infer the presence of this latent effect in an algorithm we call latent signal detection.